Like the time we bought first-class rail tickets from Louisville, Kentucky to head home to Nashville.
And a Union Pacific clerk told us we could ride in the smoking car where niggas belonged, or we could walk.
So we told the audience at the concert that night in Louisville, and there was such an uproar and a scandal that Mr. George Pullman himself, director of the Union Pacific Railroad, come to make amends to us.
He fixed up a luxury Pullman sleeper carriage for our homeward journey and promised that from that day forth, every Pullman railroad car would be integrated, free, and open to black and white the same.
Springfield to sing at Black's Opera House,
where the audience numbered fewer than 20.
But I succeeded in obtaining permission for the singers to appear before a synod of Presbyterian ministers who kept them singing for a full hour.
And testified their delight in a vociferous, heartfelt, and decidedly unclerical manner, with a hands and a feet and a voice, a whooping and a stamping and a clap.
And took up a collection of $105 for our benefit.